Go. Oh, I finally got batteries for this thing, so now I can do this and walk. I forgot So, I'm gonna ask you because I wanna understand what is cryptography? What have you heard about it? What do you think about it? What are your thoughts on it? So it involves encrypting and decrypting information. Yeah.
Using hashes.
Using hashes.
Study of effectively hiding information.
Say it louder.
Study of effectively hiding information.
Study of effectively hiding information. Do you guys use this? Do you use cryptography?
Not intentionally.
Not intentionally. Do you use it though? TLS, an encrypted connection. What else? Anything else? Do you like it? Does anybody actively use it? You're saying kind of incidentally when you're doing things, you are using cryptography, but is anybody actively encrypting things or signing or hashing things? It's not a judgment call, yeah.
I just find like GitHub commits.
Signing GitHub commits. So why do you do that? So nobody mentioned signing yet. What's signing?
Well, it's proving that I'm the person that made the commit because anybody could say should they have my email and commit to me.
Right. So yeah. So signing a message would mean that you are proving that you actually made that message. So especially important for code commits to open source projects because somebody could pretend to be you and commit. Anybody else use it? Yeah, oh, no hand. Cleaning glasses.
No, sorry.
Yeah, no, sorry.
You make a pin and then like I have an RSA key that turns it into a different hash and then that's my real temporary secondary password, I guess.
So like an RS, like you're talking about the tokens, right?
Yeah.
The RSA token. So does anybody have this for like a bank or something? Like a dedicated hardware token with a constantly changing number on it that you put in? Or anybody use two-factor authentication on Gmail or I think Dropbox uses it, a lot of people, I do too. That's all cryptography in the cryptography area. Cool, so nobody said my favorite one yet. I'll get to it in a second, I guess. Basically, cryptography is all of these things. So originally, it was the study of essentially, I mean, the name comes from the Greek words for hidden or secret and writing or study if you want to do cryptography or cryptology. Kind of the core, I mean, the core driving force in the beginning was really about keeping information secret or hidden. So this is similar to how we talked about the need for organizations to keep things secret when we talked about access control. Cryptography, you can kind of think of as what's the mechanism to how to actually do that, right? Or when we talk about encryption, if I send a note to somebody, how can I make sure that only that person can actually read it and nobody else can? Right? So we need to talk about some terminology. So somebody mentioned encryption. So what's encryption? So that's a good one. Oh. So yeah, essentially trying to transform a message so that its meaning is concealed, right? So it basically goes what you're saying. So encoding or transforming or doing something to a message to try to conceal its meaning. It may not always be successful, right? So that's kind of an important thing to keep in mind. Just because something says it's encrypted, if you don't really understand what it's doing, how it's doing it, and why, that doesn't guarantee that it's actually encrypted, that nobody except the person you want to can read that information. So then what's decryption?
Essentially the opposite, crossing it back to the meaning it is not concealed.
Yeah, so taking some encrypted message and transforming it back into the original form. So you can think of encryption, takes the message, transforms it into hopefully some gibberish that nobody can understand. Decryption takes that gibberish and transforms it into something that people can understand. So crypto system, we'll just kind of broadly define as any as a system that describes kind of how to encrypt or decrypt messages. So this could be and again, just because it has the word crypto in the name here does not mean that it actually. So I could develop a crypto system that does nothing, right? That doesn't transform the message at all. And then I can encrypt and I can decrypt. And if you don't know what I'm doing, that's not actually doing anything, you'll believe that it's encrypted. So plain text is usually what we refer to a message in its original form. So we get the crypto system gets a message in plain text, and it's trying to usually transform that through encryption to some kind of ciphertext, which would be the message in encrypted form. Yes, there are a lot of weird terms. Yes, we need to know and understand them so we can talk about them and talk about crypto systems. And a cryptographer is a person who invents encryption algorithms. I'm going to take this time, and I'm going to harp on this a lot actually, because I think it's really important. Unless you very actually know what you're doing, you are not a cartographer. Or cryptographer, sorry, cryptographer. But cartographer, I was like, yeah, you're probably not. I mean, maybe you're really into maps, I don't know. But a cryptographer in inventing and rolling your own and creating your own crypto system almost always ends in failure almost every single time. I don't have the example here, I'll bring it up later, but there's a very recent example of this. And so we want to study and understand cryptography and crypto systems so we can understand how to use them safely. Part of using them safely is knowing that you should not be ever designing your own. And that one time you're like, oh, but maybe I can do. Don't do it. Just don't do it. Go back to the drawing board. Do something else. Do something different. These things are insanely easy to mess up. I mean, I'll get to that in a second. So a cryptanalyst is somebody who has a pretty cool job as like a code breaker, whose entire job is to try to break encryption algorithms. So either the algorithms themselves, or I think the other important thing is the implementation. So that's another huge thing. And that's honestly where a lot of the flaws come from, is you can have the most beautiful, perfectly secure design and algorithm that's mathematically provable to be resistant to quantum cryptography or quantum cryptanalysis. But once you actually implement it, if there's flaws there, then it renders the whole thing moot. So this is the implementation is a huge part. So why do we want cryptography? Why do we want to keep things secret? What does that enable us in terms of security? Why are we talking about this in a security course? Yeah, so it allows us to kind of control, let's say, control information in some sense, where we can maybe release information out there, or we could say that it keeps confidential data confidential, right? So if I have some communication that's only directed to you, it should be confidential only to you. I can actually send that, and I actually don't have to worry about everyone else reading this message, because I know that you're the only person who can decrypt that message. And so I'm guaranteeing confidentiality in this sense. So I'm gonna call you GitHub developer. Does our GitHub developer care about the confidentiality of his GitHub commits? Do you?
Not super much.
No, it's actually the opposite of what you're doing, right? If you're just committing to a private repo and not telling anybody about them, you're not really making a big contribution to open source software, right? So what do you care about then?
That no one else can, like, non-forge.
Yeah, so nobody else can pretend to be you, or can, even not pretending to be you, let's say it's your original commit, but maybe they modify it in transit to insert some backdoor along the way. So we really care about integrity in those cases, right? So we care that nobody's modifying or changing the data in a way that we don't know about. So cryptography, especially with signing, as we'll get to, has a lot to do with integrity. We're gonna go back to authentication. Because we remember authentication, we talked about, an access control is trying to figure out who you are in the system, and access control is about what you can do. And so we'll see, but I want us to learn about crypto first, or cryptography first, and then we'll go to authentication. So, as we'll see there. And also, we talked about this a little bit, is non-repudiation. So for you to actually say a message, and so that you all know that, yes, I actually sent that message. So if I tell my stockbroker to buy 100 shares of Enron, and then after I do that, the stock price tanks, and I go, well, I got hacked. I never sent that message. There must be somebody spoofing my email. There's cryptographic ways that they can say, I mean, assuming I made the message that way, that they can prove, no, you actually made this message. You made this order. Cool. So crypto system, we usually think of kind of modeling it, right? We're kind of thinking, and models are really just ways to think about systems, right? So any crypto system has to have these five components, some set of plain text, so some kind of universe of plain text, some set of keys, some set of ciphertexts, and encryption functions. So an encryption function E that will take in a plain text and a key and output a ciphertext. So that will essentially map messages with a key into some ciphertext. And finally, we have D, which is a set of decryption functions, which take in ciphertext and a key and will output the message. So this is kind of very broad. Is everyone familiar with this, the syntax of the functions here? So it's basically the X and the arrow. So it basically is defining E as a set of functions. So the function signature of each of these functions in E is, kind of, you can think inputs are any plain text and any key. And then the output is something, so the input is something from M, something from K, and the output is something from C, right? So think of this like a type signature. You write a function called encrypt, which takes in a message, which is a plain text message, and takes in a key and outputs ciphertext. Similarly, decryption is exactly the same way, but takes in a ciphertext and a key and outputs a message. So for instance, so the Caesar cipher, before we get to this, so does anybody, maybe I should have said this before my rant, but has anybody actually created a crypto system before in their lives? Note passing? Yeah? In what sense? Like a computer one or a written one?
The written one.
Written one? Would you like to share it? You don't have to. Or maybe the context?
So you take the first half of the letters of the alphabet,
mm-hmm.
and then you lay them and replace them with the second half of all the letters of the alphabet.
Mm-hmm.
Works super great.
Cool. Yeah, that's a good one. I think we'll look at that. I think it's a ROT 13.
E became Z and N became M.
Oh, so you flipped it this way.
Something, yeah.
Yeah, okay, I see. Because otherwise, you, you stack. this way, A would be N or M or whatever.
So you basically have a lock secrets.
Yeah, so that's cool, like a flipping, that's cool. Anybody else? I had one in like, I would say it's like fourth or fifth, probably fifth grade, where we would write a sentence and it would be the first letter of the sentences, no, sorry, the first letter of the words in the sentence would then be the actual message, right? So trying to hide a message by adding a bunch of random gibberish. It did not work very well. I mean, got broken, but I won't talk about that. So one of the most famous ciphers, and kind of one of the oldest, is the Caesar cipher. So the name actually comes from Julius Caesar, and I have this quote from, apparently from a Roman text, from a Roman, history person? That's not right. Historian, there you go, yeah. I know there's a word. If he had anything confidential to say, he wrote it in cipher. That is, by so changing the order of the letters of the alphabet that not a word could be made out. If anyone wishes to decipher these and get at their meaning, he must substitute the fourth letter of the alphabet, namely D, for A, and so on with the other ones. So similarly, a similar kind of scheme of essentially shifting the letters of the alphabet, in this case, forward three. And so we can actually, so we'll get into this, an example of this, but we can model this essentially in our modeling way, that where M is all the letters that you want to encrypt, K would be, all of your keys would essentially be integers, so an integer that would tell you how much to shift the alphabet. E would be a function, so for the K and all letters M, so to make an encryption out of a Caesar cipher encryption from K for a letter M, you take M mod K mod 26, right? So this just says shift it to the right, so add, and then the mod makes sure when we loop around, so if we're adding to Z, we'll loop around to the back of the start, and with K subtract, so it's moving backwards, and this the ciphertext language is the same as the messages, right? So we're not, our alphabet there is not changing in our ciphertext and our messages. All right, so when we come back, we'll learn how to attack this.
I think